So we talked about human level performance, but I want to take a bit more of time to really tell you what human level performance is. So basically, when you are building machine learning models, you are trying to more or less reach to a level that is usable, right? If a human can do the same task 10 times better than a machine can do, then there is not much of a point to have an algorithm that is being trained to do this task. So that's why when we are building models, we have to compare it to something. And one of the things that we can compare it to is human level performance. Then we have Bayes' optimal error. And this error is basically the amount of error that is possible to achieve in the least. So you cannot go lower than this amount of error. But of course, right now we're looking at an accuracy graph. It is the amount of performance that you can achieve max. So there is no way, human or machine, to go beyond this level. This can be zero sometimes. So for example, the error, the Bayes' optimal error, could be zero. Maybe it will be possible to do a task perfectly, completely perfectly. But for most tasks, it's actually a bit higher than zero. And by definition, it's always higher than the human performance. So because at least the human performance needs to be worse than either equal to or worse than Bayes' optimal performance, because there is nothing better than Bayes' optimal performance. And what happens while we're training models is that models take not that long of a time to achieve human performance, because we can either collect more data from humans that were labeled by humans. We can see how humans are approaching a certain problem and understand or get tips and tactics from their approach to this problem, or just basically any other input, because basically until we're reaching human performance, we are aware of what humans are doing to achieve this performance. But after human performance, it's kind of like uncharted territory. That's why progress seems to be slower. And we can never really get higher than Bayes' optimal. You can get really close to it. Maybe you can even achieve it, but you cannot really get past it. So these are just some definitions that's good to keep in mind. How do we decide what human performance is, though? Okay, so let's look at an example. Let's say we have a data set that has long medical sentences, and we are trying to find how many drug names are mentioned in each sentence. We are trying to find the locations where these drug names are mentioned. So in this specific example, it's talking about a paper that has two different medicines, and one of them is called ipilimumab and nivolumab, let's say. I'm not even sure if these are drug names, by the way. They probably are, based on the context of the whole sentence. And let's say we put this data set in front of people that has a lot of these sentences, long medical sentences. And then for an inexperienced person, just a normal person like you and me, unless you are a doctor or a medical professional, that person got on average 1.5 mistakes, and a doctor got 0.9% mistakes, a pharmacist was able to get only 0.5% mistakes, and a group of pharmacists, so if we put, let's say, 3-5 pharmacists together, and then they look at this example, and then they discuss, and then they tell us what the drug names are or where they are, then it will be 0.3% mistakes. So if we're trying to find the Bayes' optimal error, all we can say, looking at this table, is that I'm going to take 0.3 for Bayes' optimal error. Because let's say we have no idea what the maximum possible performance we can achieve for the specific task. All we have is this table and these numbers. Then what we can take is the best number possible. A group of pharmacists were able to achieve 0.3% error only. So that means that is a possibility. It could be higher or lower than that. It could be zero. It could be 0.1, 0.2. We don't know that. As far as we know, Bayes' optimal error is 0.3. But this doesn't mean that your model should aspire to be 0.3. Because depending on your context, a lower error might actually, or a higher error might actually be fine with you. Let's say you are a research group and you are trying to make this or achieve this or make the model that achieves this goal, and you don't have any doctors around, and the best thing you can do is basically the inexperienced person level, and you are just trying to look for something that is better than your current situation. So let's say the people are doing it manually and they are making mistakes here and there, and their error rate is 1.5. So basically you can say, you know what, I'm going to aspire to the doctor level because that's already a little bit higher than what I can achieve right now. And as far as I can get 0.9 error, that's going to be good for me or good for my application or good for my solution. So you don't always have to aspire for the Bayes optimal error. You can only just aspire to the human level too, based on, you know, what you determine the human level should be. So there are some considerations, of course, based on what you choose your model should aspire to, because that's how we're going to decide what kind of improvements to make for our model. So let's look at an example. We have human level performance that we are going to determine what it is. And then we have the performance on the training set. And then we have the performance on the validation set. The reason that human level performance, or what we determine to be human level performance, is important is because, as I said, that's going to be the factor that determines what we should do with our model to improve it. The difference between the human level performance and the performance on the training set, we call it the bias difference, the difference in the biases. And it's actually, it does make sense, right? Because if your performance on the training set is way lower than the human level performance, it might mean that your model is not able to fit the training data super well. So what does that mean? It's underfitting. And as we talked about, underfitting is caused by high bias. So basically, if you are not able to fit the data as well as you could have based on the human level performance, that means that you should lower your bias. Or on the other hand, if your performance on the training set is good, but not on the validation set, then we call this the variance difference. And again, as we talked about, if you're fitting well on the training set and not on validation set, that means you're overfitting. And the problem is that you have a high variance, so you want to lower the variance. So that's why we follow that tradition of how bias and variance is in while we're diagnosing our model. So let's look at an example here. Let's say we decided the performance that we're going to aspire to is the performance of group of pharmacists, and that was 0.3. And on the training set, we achieved 1%. On the validation set, we achieved 4%. So at this point, we have to stop and think what to spend time on. Are we going to spend time on lowering the bias difference? Or are we going to spend time on lowering the variance difference? Because the solution to each of them are a little bit different. If you are trying to lower bias, you're going to try different things. If you are trying to lower variance, you're going to try different things. So what we can do in that point is to look at the differences. Between the human level and the training set performance, we have 0.7% difference. And for the training set and validation set, we have 3% difference. So it's quite easy to see that we would have more gain to work on the variance difference to improve our model. We will be able to make more progress. But whereas for the bias difference, we are already quite close compared to the variance difference. But what if our model was a bit more different? Let's say we are still trying to achieve 0.3% based on group of pharmacists' performance. Our training set performance is again 1, but our validation performance, our performance on the validation set is 1.2. Well, then the difference actually changed. We have 0.7 performance difference and 0.2 performance difference for the variation difference. So then, actually, instead of the variation difference, it makes more sense to focus on the bias difference because it's higher than 3 times the variance difference. So at this point, you will have more gain if you focused on lowering the bias. But as I said, depending on what we choose the human level performance to be, these decisions could change too. So let's say instead of group of pharmacists, we want to aspire to the level that one single doctor achieves. So that one was 0.9. So all of a sudden, even if the model doesn't change, our bias difference ends up being 0.1. So what do we want to do then? So we look at the difference. Basically, our bias difference is 0.1 in either case, but our variance difference is 3 in one of them. Like last time, we again wanted to choose 3. We wanted to lower the variance difference in the first case too. But even for the second case, we see that the variance difference is 2 times the bias difference. So what you want to do is, again, work on the variance difference, even in the second case. So this is how choosing your human level performance would change what kind of solution you're going to come up with after this diagnosis level for your model to make it better and to make it perform at a more acceptable level.